Hi, my name is Suzette and welcome to Block Plays. I never really knew Lego as a kid. My parents couldn't really afford it, but when I met Franz, he came home with a big crate of Lego one day and said that we must sort it out. It was obviously the Lego that his kids were playing with, and it took us about 2 weeks to get it all built and sorted. And it just, the bug bit me. What really fascinated me about Lego was the way that they would recreate a scene into something that looked almost exactly like it did in the movies. Obviously, the techniques they used to do it was something that baffled me, because I didn't know that you could actually do that with blocks. What really stands out for me is the Harry Potter series. I've been a Harry Potter fan since I can remember, and it's probably the fantasy, and also I read the books before I watched the movies, which is even better. And I loved the way that Lego took that and recreated it into something that I can create as well. I mean, it feels like I'm taking part in the Harry Potter world when I build the sets, and I just love it. And I love the detail they have inside there, little small Easter eggs, if you can call it that. The Hogwarts Castle actually has all sorts of different rooms. One has the Chamber of Secrets, and where there's a statue of a snake, and then there's also one from the first movie where they had to go through trials, where there's a giant chess set that they actually have to play, and also there's like flying keys that they has to catch on a broomstick, stuff like that. It's just small Easter eggs that represents more than one movie or more than one scene. And I love it. So when I first started with Lego, I didn't even know that there were Harry Potter sets. So one day I started doing some research and I found this train, which is the old one, and I said to Franz that I have to have this because it's probably the most exquisite train I've ever seen in any movie anyway. And also this set, this Diagon Alley, it's one of the rarest sets, but it represents very good moments for me in the movie. When I think about Diagon Alley, the first thing I think about is all the funny animals that you saw there, all the funny insects and all the magical places and hidden chambers and all those type of things. So I got excited when I saw these sets, because Diagon Alley is a magical place and I love that. So I really, really wanted these sets, and we were lucky enough to get them. Well, this train was actually a birthday gift from Franz a couple of years ago, and I was really ecstatic about it. I didn't even think that you could find one and it was still sealed, but I had to build it. So this Diagon Alley set I bought from a guy on Facebook. It was secondhand, but it's in impeccable condition. And it wasn't even that expensive. A little bit, but not that much. And I saw it and I grabbed it. I had to. Franz and I built a lot of Lego together. I feel that it's a lot of good quality time that we spend when we actually sit and build, even if we don't talk much because we're concentrating on what we're doing, but it's something that we can enjoy as a couple. Doing it together, I feel like sometimes it brings us even closer. And we share ideas. He gives me his opinion, I give him my opinion, and it's win-win. And obviously he doesn't have to hide how much he spends on Lego. Thank you for watching this episode. Please remember to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell.